In this video, we'll look at the three steps involved in using the Cogent DataHub to share data between Excel applications over a network. First, we will configure the DataHub on a Windows Server 2012 computer to read data from a master Excel application. Then, we'll configure another DataHub running on a Windows 7 client computer to tunnel the data from the DataHub running on the server. And finally, we'll use the DataHub drag and drop feature to copy the data from the DataHub on the client into the client Excel application. So here we are on our Windows Server 2012 computer. And as you can see, I have an Excel application up and running. And this Excel spreadsheet has been configured to read several incoming data streams. These are just representative data. They don't actually signify anything. But they're updating at roughly about 2 hertz or twice a second. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to start the Cogent DataHub. And then we're going to configure DDE connections from our Excel spreadsheet to the DataHub. So I'll double click on the DataHub and then I'm going to choose DDE. And over in our Excel spreadsheet, we're going to make things a little easier for ourselves. Rather than referencing the cells by column and row number, we're going to do something different. We're going to name the cells. So this cell currently contains some data that's updating, and I'm going to change it so that instead of B3, I'm going to call this, let's call it my cell 1. So that's named this cell. And what I'm also going to do while I'm here is I'm going to name this range of cells. So I'm going to call this my range 1. So I have a cell called my cell 1 and a range here called my range 1. Over in the Data Hub, I'm going to configure a DDE client connection. So I'm going to click on the Add button. And first I'm going to define just a connection name for this. So my Excel link. The service name is a DDE service name, and for Excel, this is just simply Excel. And the topic name is the name of our spreadsheet. In this case, it's called serverbook1.xlsx. serverbook1.xlsx. And now the item name is the name that we put in for our cell. So I'm going to do the first one is going to be my cell 1. I'm going to click Add. Now I want the data that I read from Excel, I want these data points to be stored in a data domain within the Data Hub. We're given default as a suggested place to store the data, but I'm going to double click on there and change this to server XL. So that's the domain name that we're going to use for storing the data that we read out of this master Excel spreadsheet on the server. If I click OK, you can see that our status has been updated to connected. If I come down here and look at the data, you can see that under our server XL data domain, we now have a Data Hub's point name called MyCell, and you'll notice that every half a second it's getting updated with information that we're pulling out of the spreadsheet. Now let's go back and modify this. I'm just going to add the name that we had for our range, which was called range 1. And if I add that, you can see that it's being added in there. If I click OK, Then if we come back over to our data data browser, you'll see that in the Data Hub we now have a cell, a single updating point, and we now have an array of data which represents this range within Excel. Ranges are very useful because they allow us to transmit a large amount of information, and this is just a very small range, but you can have a range of hundreds of columns by hundreds of rows, and that particular that range of data will be broadcast between data hubs as a single point value, an array point. And whenever any of the cells within the array update, the whole array is broadcast across the network. So now on our server we have a data hub that contains a data hub domain name of server Excel, and it contains two points that we've read from our master Excel spreadsheet. So now let's go over to our Windows 7 computer and configure the data hub there to connect to this data hub running on the server. So here we are over in my Windows 7 computer, and I will run the data hub over here as well. And let's bring up the properties window for the data hub. And what we're going to do is configure a tunnel mirror connection. And what we want to do is we want to configure a slave connection, which means that this data hub will initiate a connection to the data hub on the master. So I click to add a master, and I'm going to type in the IP address for my 2012 server. And over here I want to call, I want the data to be stored in a data domain called client Excel. And if you remember, over on the server we want to look for data in a data domain called server Excel. So that's all we need to do. I'll click OK, and then if we click apply, you'll see that our status has changed to running. And if I click on view data here, you can see that we now have a client Excel data domain over here in Windows 7, and you'll notice that it's connected to the data hub on the server, and it's reading the two points, both the single cell reference and the range reference over here on the client side. So that's how easy it is. Now the last stage in the process is for me to open Excel here on the client, and simply from our Cogent data browser window we click on the data point we're interested in and we simply drag it over into our spreadsheet, and there is the data updating in our spreadsheet. Now when we drag our range across, there is our range updating in our spreadsheet. So pretty simple really. We configured the data hub on the server to read data from the master Excel spreadsheet. We then came over to the data hub on the client side and we configured a tunnel mirror connection that read data from the data hub running on the server. We opened up our data browser and we dragged our data into Excel. And you'll see this data is running at about twice a second. The connection is very quick. And one thing I wanted to point out, to stop data writes back to the server, you can change the data flow direction so that this is a read-only data connection. If we click OK on that and apply, we have now restarted the connection, and what that means is that there's no way for us to write data back over to the server. By default, you would have noticed that we actually were set up to read and write, which means you can set up Excel with macros to actually write data back out to the data hub on this side, and the information can flow in both directions. Anyway, that's a quick little video to show you how easy it is to use the Cogent Data Hub to network Excel data between a server and client computers. If you have any questions or you'd like to see some more information, please visit the documentation section of the website at www.cogentdatahub.com.